and thanks for joining us on Around the Peninsula. I'm Maria Sorreo. Today we're celebrating Well the Day, which is an annual event sponsored by the city of Rancho Palos Verdes and the docent group Los Serenos de Point Vicente. Now it takes a lot of people to put Well the Day together every year, so let's go find out from Mona Dill and Corey Linder how they get it all done.
We've got some fantastic staff, and we also have a great partnership with the docents. The docents, this is their baby. They take it very seriously, and we'll probably start meeting on next week's or next year's next week. So these guys, they take it very seriously. This is a big event for them. The city, we feel it's one of our flagships as well. So we put all into this as well. We want to give the residents, but also the public. A taste of what we've got here.
So we have close to several thousand people that come to this event. It goes on for about 3 months of preparation, solid. But a lot of it goes on about a year before this event. So we're at it all year round. These volunteers are awesome. They're always ready to go. So we almost have to turn people away. We have so many people. We have students from local high schools. Los Serenos docents, of course, absolutely rock. So they're really a great, great help at this event.
I know that people come here every year because they want to see whales. And this has been a record number of whales today. Tell us about that.
Well, today was like 37. I think yesterday was 78. But this year has been going really, really well.
So you've been to a few Well of the Days now. What's your favorite part of coming out here today?
I just like seeing all the people. I like it after we've gotten everything squared away and all the kinks knocked out, we're able to enjoy it ourselves. And that's what I like to get out and talk to people like you and to talk to other people and see, what do you guys think? How do you like it here? You know, is this something, a lot of people had no idea it was here. So it's great to be able to share it.
Now, Well of the Day brings out thousands of people from our community and beyond. Here are some of our local leaders who would never miss Well of the Day. 32nd annual Well of the Day celebration. Tell us why this is an important event for the city to do for the community.
Well, it's an amazing thing to highlight some of the special things about Rancho Palos Verdes, about the peninsula, and about the history of this community and this peninsula over time. I mean, I was just looking at a whale out there right now. I mean, very close to shore and very, very special here. And I think it's one of those great community events that's great to get kids here and adults here. There's fun and enjoyment and education for everybody at all levels. And so, boy, 32 years, it's amazing.
This really does bring the community together. We see neighbors, you see people you don't see all the time. The kids have a great time. Every year we educate people on what it is to live in Rancho Palos Verdes. We've seen whales all morning over here. We're lucky we got a great day today. A couple years we've had some rain, but it does bring the community together and a lot of people that don't see each other on a regular basis, including a lot of the kids, which I like to see get together. And it's like a small town picnic. We have the 4th of July event, which is very much similar to this, same feel. And I'm really happy about the unity and the esprit de corps of the community here, and it really showcases what we have here in RPV.
Look at how beautiful today is. Whale of a Day always falls on such a gorgeous March day. I mean, it's a great place for people to come to the Palos Verdes Peninsula and enjoy the ocean, see the beautiful sea life, especially the whales. And I understand there's like 25, 27 whale sightings today. And see our beautiful city.
It's kind of amazing. This is a record number of whales today, and they're kind of in the middle of the migration. But so many people have seen so many whales today. Have you ever seen a whale?
I've seen many whales. I've seen whales up close when I was working on fishing boats. I had one come so close that it looked up at me, and we made eye contact.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow. Well, we were talking to some of the cetacean people and people that count for the census, and they're so dedicated, but not a bad way to volunteer for a job, is it?
Oh, no. A whale is a majestic mammal, and it is a very important part of our ecosystem. So I think whales are, I love whales. You know, I love whales.
I come out every year because this is a first sign of almost spring. Also because it is a real celebration that we have this amazing interpretive center at Point Vicente, that we're now world renowned. We're a destination, not only are we a destination city, but this particular location is an insignia around the world. And I mean, we're so blessed to be here. I would say we're in paradise.
We see whale watchers that come here from all over the world just for this day.
Yes. And a lot of them become docents because they start out watching the whales, about how people get started just walking by the Cetacean Society and seeing what they're doing, and then they become counters, and then they see how wonderful it is here at the Interpretive Center, and they become docents.
It's not a horrible way to volunteer, is it, Susan?
Oh, it's a tough day in paradise, right?
Well, it's always a fun time here at Whale of a Day, whether you're a whale watcher or a whale enthusiast. Let's go find out more from Lisa Baragosh and Caitlin Sumko. You have a big job out here, Libby. Tell us about watching the whales and taking the census.
Well, today, for example, we got here quite early. We got here before 6 in the morning and got set up, ready to go. So when it's light, we can hopefully spot whales. And we have special binoculars that we use when we see something, and inside they have a compass and lines for mils, for distance. And then we have to track what we spot, whatever direction. If they're northbound, like the ones today, they go from left to right, or the other direction earlier in the year.
I'm noticing it's very active today. Tell us why that happens.
We don't know, but most of the whales were not as friendly and showy as the last pod, the big pod of 6. But we've had 3 cow calves today, moms with babies, and all 3 of them had a spare whale. So it was like 2 adults and 1 calf. And that's quite common.
Okay. And how long have you been doing this, and how did you get started?
Well, I got started taking my kids to a field trip in San Pedro in 1968, I think, and I got addicted to I grew up watching whales when I was little, where I lived, and it was fun because I met John O'Gean, and he said, well, you got to come back, because I had asked him about a piece of something I'd found at the beach, and it was baleen, so I have that at home, and so I started watching, and we started at San Pedro using right in front of their lighthouse. We had our little hand compass and our little thing. We had to write down what we saw, and then Elisa and John, I guess, worked with her too. I'm not sure about that, but they worked together to create an actual routine. So our job is to count the whales and see how many we can get in each direction, and our census starts December 1st, and it goes through at least, probably it will go through June. It used to go through May 15th.
So this is pretty much the heart of the season then, is that right?
Well, we're at turnaround. Well, they've turned around, so most of them are going north now. They had one yesterday, I believe, or the day before. They still have southbounders. We'll still be going the wrong way for a while.
What's your favorite part about being out here on Whale of a Day?
Oh, hoping and seeing whales, because sometimes we were out here and we didn't see a darn thing in the morning. And the weather is so much nicer than it usually is, too.
I'm a docent normally inside the museum. I also work as a docent on the whale boats. I'm the guy with the microphone, the whale watch boats. But today I'm in charge of the whale wagon. And so I get people to come in and I try to give them some excuse to come over and I tell them all about the whales.
I've also been told you are the official bell ringer for today. Is that correct?
Oh, yes. I got a bell right here. And when we ring the bell, that means that there's a whale. And so everybody knows that then to come and see the whales.
Wow, that's amazing. Now, how many whales do you anticipate that we'll see today?
Well, we've got 12 or 13 at least already, and it's only like in the morning, so hopefully we'll have a lot.
Can I ring the bell?
Oh, well, why not?
I don't see it.
We are a nonprofit, and our mission is to rehabilitate sick, injured, and orphan native birds, and to do a lot of wildlife and environmental education. So we see about 30,000 people a year in education, and we take in anywhere from 1,000 to 1,500 birds.
And who is it you have here?
This is Eddie, and Eddie is a great horned owl. He came in 2005, 5, I think. Anyhow, he came in, he was hit by a car, and it broke his wing and also damaged his right eye. So he, like any of the birds here, is not releasable. If he were to get out in the wild, he would die.
So did somebody find him on the side of the road?
Yes, somebody found him locally on the side of the road where he'd run after prey and brought him to us.
Yeah. Wow. So how many birds per year do you usually have? Like, how many people coming to you with injured or animals that they found?
We get them from all over the South Bay, from north to the valley, south to central Orange County, east almost to Riverside and west to Catalina. And so anybody in that area, anybody who wants to bring us something, we get from animal controls, people off the street. We also help USDA. They trap at 7 airports, and they bring them to us. And we look for somebody who's traveling anywhere from 50 to 200 plus miles away to relocate them. It's a great thing to do. It's fun.
Yeah, amazing. And tell me, how is it being here at the Whale of the Day?
I think we've been here every year since it started, which is a very long time, and we've had this very spot every time. It's one of our favorite events.
Tell us a little bit about what's kind of going on here today.
Well, today, as you can see, we're doing Whale of a Day, right? And the Coast Guard is known for its safety, security, and stewardship missions. Stewardship, you know, we talk about marine environmental protection, mammal protection, living marine resources. That's a key component of what we do on a day-to-day basis. So we came out here to kind of support and showcase what the Coast Guard has for resources, talk about the wonderful people that do the missions, and kind of support the local community. That's kind of why we're here today.
It's very busy. There's a lot of people out here. They're having a lot of fun, learning about lots of animals, lots of different vendors talking about conservation and animals today. We've been here a number of years in a row. We're a very popular attraction, and a lot of people like to come and hang out, see our animals outside of the aquarium, and some people never get to go to the aquarium. We've actually met a number of people today that have never seen us in Long Beach, and they get a chance to see our animals right here at the Whale of a Day Festival.
What is your favorite part about experiencing this event?
My favorite part is definitely when you see those people that have never touched an anemone or a sea star or even a little shark. We have a baby shark on the truck, a swell shark, and a lot of people have never seen these animals up close. They never get a chance to hang out with nature and experience them in their home habitat. So we bring them out for people to experience in a safe and very confident and comfortable area.
What is this here we're looking at?
This is the giant green anemone. It's like many other anemones you see in the ocean. They have their tentacles that stick up. They have their long body. And if you want, you can try and touch them. These are one of the animals in the touch pools that you can interact with.
I can touch it right now?
Yeah.
Just
okay. Like right here. You don't have to be afraid.
Wow.
Their tentacles will stick to you a little bit. That's actually how they would hold onto their food. So if you were something to eat, they'd start curling their tentacles in towards their mouth, and you might get swallowed.
Wow.
But you're too strong. You wouldn't be held. Everybody gets a chance to interact with the anemones, so this is a very common thing that people get to experience on our truck.
It's quite slimy.
Yeah, they have a mucus coat that covers their body. It actually is kind of like sunscreen, protects them.
Oh, interesting. And how about this, the starfish?
Yeah, this is our ochre star. So you can go ahead and touch them. They have a very different texture than the anemone. They have bony plates in their skin, so that texture, that rough texture you're feeling, are the bony plates that help protect them. It's an adaptation so that not very many animals want to come and try and chew on them during a low tide and they're exposed to the open air.
Can I touch under his leg?
You wouldn't want to. They like to hold hands, and they don't let go.
Can I try?
You could try. You just don't want to hold on for too long because their little toes, they have thousands of little tube feet on the underside of their body. And that's how they hold on to the rocks. That's why they're so strong. They don't get washed away during tidal differences in the water splashing against them.
He doesn't seem to be interested in holding my hand.
Not really. These two have been hanging out for a while. They don't want to hang out with anybody else.
So tell me a little bit about your booth that you are manning here.
We call Dance for Oceans. This is the grassroots volunteer group that raises awareness about pollution in the ocean, especially trash pollution. And especially the plastic trash is so severe right now, and it's serious problems in everywhere in the world. So we raise awareness by showing the trash samples, and also we do performance at 1:30 this afternoon. And we were going to wear some trash clothes. And then we do a lot of film screenings, beach cleanup, and public speech, all that stuff. And we just want to raise awareness of the plastic trash pollution, but also we want to educate people how to stop the pollution.
What is your favorite part of this special day?
First of all, we can see the whales counting, what is it, like 80 or 90 whales every day. It's just wonderful. And a beautiful place here, in the surrounded by the ocean, blue ocean and green hills. This is the wonderful, the most wonderful annual event in Palos Verdes. And then you get to see earthy people who care about the planet.
Ladies, you beautiful mermaid ladies, tell me, what are you doing here at the Whale of the Day event?
We're here to celebrate the beautiful migration of the whales and educate children about the importance of keeping our oceans safe.
And your booth, you're all dressed as mermaids. Tell me, why is that?
Well, we love being mermaids. Usually in the morning, noon, and night, we're swimming in the ocean, and today we decided to kind of drag our tails out of the sea and come and join all the children today.
Fantastic. Is this your first time at Whale of the Day?
This is our first time at Whale of the Day, and we're really excited to be here.
What's been your favorite part so far?
Oh my gosh, I just think all the kids running around and being so enchanted by everything going on.
Talk to me about being in your tails. Is it difficult to move around?
Yes, it's almost impossible to move around. It's like not having legs anymore.
But swimming is pretty easy, right?
Swimming is actually better with a tail on than with your legs. Much faster.
They are so beautiful, these tails, and I really want to try one on. Can I try one on?
You absolutely can try one on.
Okay.
Go right for it.
32nd Whale of the Day celebration. We hope that you are going to enjoy this beautiful day.
Woo, look at you. You did it. You're a fin fun mermaid.
I did.
You are. You're not one of us. What's your mermaid name?
My mermaid name? Bubbles.
Oh, mermaid Bubbles. I knew it. I knew it. You definitely look like Bubbles.
What has been your favorite part of the day so far?
So far, I think the jumpy house. My daughter loves the jumpy house.
And looking around, is there anything you guys really want to do today that you haven't yet?
We haven't checked everything out yet, but the crafts are fun for the kids.
And is this your first time here at Whale of a Day?
Yes, it is.
What has been your favorite part about today?
The jumper.
Uh-huh. And have you been here many times before?
Yeah.
And so since you've been here before and you kind of know what to expect, is there anything else that you're really looking forward to about doing today?
The art craft?
The arts and crafts.
How's it going today? Are you enjoying the event?
Absolutely. This is so much fun. We've had such a good time. We've seen whales and had face painting and played games, and it's been fantastic.
And what has been your favorite part of today?
Getting face paint.
Did you see any whales?
No.
Is this your first year coming?
Yeah, it is. Been having a great time. We came here from further up in LA just to see the whales, and we happened to come across this great festival.
Oh, amazing. So you didn't even know the event was happening today?
No, not until last night when we looked up directions.
And where are you from?
Bel Air.
First time, Christina, she found it on the internet website, and she wanted to go. So this is pretty much her function. I'm just here because I'm the dad, and they have games for my daughter. So that's another reason why I'm here. So you'd have to ask to the head honcho right here.
And are you enjoying? So this is your first time?
Yeah, this is our first time. I thought it'd be great kids' activities and bonding experience with Jaslyn.
Now, in addition to watching whales, the docents from Los Serenos de Point Vicente teach us about these amazing animals. Let's catch up with Lisa Baragosh and find out more.
I'm a docent, and I've been a docent here for about 22 years. And I'm part of the Restoral crew of the whale boat here. This is an authentic whale boat that was used at Portuguese Bend at the whaling station that was there. And they usually had between two and four whale boats. They used to have minimum of two boats, because if one got stove, then they would have to have another boat to go rescue the sailors. All the docents are schooled. And like you met the junior docents out in front, and they're schooled on every aspect of the interpreter center. When you go through the interpreter center, there's archaeology, We have a lot of beautiful, we have a rocks formation of sharks that go back thousands and thousands of years. It's probably one of the best shark exhibits in the country. We have the whale, which is called Serena, and we actually, a group of us, put the whale together. And we had it hung in the lobby. So everybody that comes here, if they just look up, they would see Serena. And it's a skeleton. And it's a junior whale, a gray whale. We like to bring the people here to celebrate the migration of the Pacific gray whale. The Pacific gray whale migration is from Baja California all the way up to Crescent City. And actually goes further in Crescent City, goes to Alaska. And this is the time that the Pacific gray whale is traversing past this part of the country. And the migration route is fantastic. If you stay right here out in front, you can see whales come to the surface. This is a celebration for the migration of the Pacific gray whale. Other than that, people can sit outdoors and really take that in because it's not a normal happening. The East Coast doesn't have it. There's other parts of the world that have a migration, but not like this one right here. They were almost extinct at one point, about 1850. But basically, they're coming to see the whales.
Now, the Point Vicente Lighthouse is a landmark here in Rancho Palos Verdes, so we have sent our student reporter, Caitlin Semko, inside to show you more.
Tell us a little bit about the lighthouse and what you have going on here.
The lighthouse is actually very special today because it's 90 years old. So actually at noon, we're going to sing Happy Birthday Lighthouse. And what is significant is even with modern navigation and GPS, this particular lighthouse is still needed today by the mariners coming up and down the coast of California and in from Asia. They, even in a modern electronic world, this lighthouse still is operational and is needed for navigation as it was 90 years ago. So here we are in the room just below the lamp room of the lighthouse. We're about 80 feet in the air, and the guests today are climbing the ladder up to see the lens. It's the third size of lenses in lighthouses. It's about 6 feet tall, and the 1,000-watt bulb that's up there, it projects out to sea 24 miles. So you can see this lighthouse out to Catalina. It runs 24 hours a day and has been running 24 hours a day since 1926. The only thing that's changed is the bulb went from a huge theater spotlight style bulb to a little bitty halogen bulb, still 1,000 watts, still needed today for modern navigation.
And that will do it for this year's Well of a Day. We sure hope you had a well of a time. I'm Maria Sorreo, and we'll see you next time on Around the Peninsula.
Well, you too can get one if you come to Whale of a Day and get a free hat.
You know, I guess just a thank you to the city of Rancho Palos Verdes for allowing us to come here and be part of the community. And a thank you to our Coast Guard Auxiliary. They're an arm of the Coast Guard that consists of about 30,000 volunteers that support the Coast Guard in many different ways all across our nation. And so many of the people we have here today that are representing our service are Coast Guard Auxiliary.
I really fit into Whale of the Day now.
Now, why did you decide to become a mermaid today?
I just felt the transformation was real. It needed to happen. You guys inspired me with your beauty and flowing tails and locks.
Well, you just sprouted your first tail.
Do you girls want to go swimming now?
Yeah! Yeah.